By the year 6538 AD, the human race of planet Earth, for better and for worse, had expanded from its humble roots within the solar system to a mighty Terran Empire that now spanned the universe. The exponential growth of FTL technology, combined with borrowed tech from all the subjugated races, ensured that every planet known surrendered to our rule, but still the humans wondered of the undiscovered places. And so a fleet of ships commanded by our finest minds set off on a great and highly touted expedition to explore the very edges of the universe we knew, to find new worlds and tech and resources for acquisition. The fleet went past the furthest star and then went right on going, towards a darkness so deep that it made them hesitate. But dauntless they pressed on into this yawning emptiness, into which no light from any star could penetrate. After weeks of journey through the suffocating black, it reached the fleet commanders that a scout ship was destroyed. It had flown ahead some distance to perform reconnaissance, so the fleet sped up to learn what it had found within the void. The scout ship was not shot down, but appeared for all the world like it had flown full speed into a wall of solid rock. The blackness ended just ahead, and past that point, within its stead, there was a vast and vibrant redness that now left their passage blocked. It soon became apparent that no ship or weapon built could smash a hole in this red wall, or even make a dent. The fleet split up and tried to find a way around the blockage, but it seemed to stretch forever, no matter where the scouters went. But then they found that there were giant markings on the wall. They vowed to analyze them, lest this be a total loss. They seemed to be part of a sequence of numbers and letters. Each character was 27,000 miles across. It took them 30 years to travel up and down the wall and get every single symbol in the sentence written down. Only then did they conclude they couldn't understand it, so they sent it to be translated by linguists of renown. After months of research, the commanders were most eager to know the meaning of this sentence and their whole excursion. A white-faced linguist then emerged and told them that it read, "Pay $9.99 to unlock full version."
Dear PlayStation Vita, I like you quite a bit, but please can you stop fucking up with all the fucking shit? If you can't download your games with any sense of speed, the least that you could bloody do is understand my needs. I don't know what you think goes on in Vita owner lives, but I'm too busy to let entire days take fucking dives. I don't know the reason, the stupid fucking cause, but when downloading games, I don't want the thing to fucking pause. I cannot sit and watch the fucking shit download bar creep for fear that downloading will stop when the Vita sleeps. I would much prefer to set the download and not care. Instead, if I'm to keep it going, I stop it all and stare. It really puts a dampener on one's portable fun when you see progress bars half full instead of fucking done. The industry wants digital to come to common folk, but that will never happen while it's all a fucking joke. And people wonder why an online-only console sucked. There's no way implementation would not have been way fucked. And yes, I changed the settings so the Wi-Fi was persistent, and no, that didn't fucking work, this shit is inconsistent. And I bet when I've got this recording here and done in hand, I still have not finished obtaining fucking Borderlands. Yet other systems do it right, it cannot be that hard. And fuck's sake, Sony, sort those fucking fucked memory cards.